So after copying, now nitakuja hapa katika hii command prompt, ambayo ni kuiopen hii hapa. So nikija kuipaste hapa, for example, now nikipaste, okay, so now you can see alter table out of stock, add primary key ID. Kwa hiyo nikija kuirun hapa au nikirun hapa, the same, okay. So now paste it. So alter table out of stock, add primary key, a primary key is ID. So now click enter to execute, okay. Now good, another step is to add a primary key kwenye sold item table. So now you can see this is a sold item table, so we need to add a primary key. So look at the primary key. Primary key ni go say he transaction ID and medicine ID to be a primary key. So in sold items table we'll have two primary keys, okay. So the first primary key will be transaction ID and second primary key will be medicine ID. Na moja ya rules kwenye table haitaki contain two primary keys. Table should have only single primary key. So kwa nini tunasema primary key mbili zitaikwaje? So combination of two primary keys, hiyo key itaitwa composite, okay. So this will be composite key and composite, see, composite. A composite key is a combination of two fields. And field mbili zote lazima ziwe zimekidhi mahitaji zimehitaja kwamba zinafaa kuwa primary key. So hizi zitakuwa ni composite key. So this one will be a primary key ambayo ni transaction ID, and medicine ID will be also a primary key. A combination of two keys in a form composite key. Okay. Okay. So again, we'll add a key. Total key kwenye what medicine ID. So medicine ID, of course, itakuwa na nyani key. So medicine ID will be a composite and also will be a key, unique key. Okay. So now, nikija hapa kwenye code, tachukufanya hivi. So here I want to create a composite key. Okay. So nitaandika keyword inaitwa alter. Okay. Yes. Okay. So nitaandika keyword inaitwa alter. Then fatiwa na nini ambacho nataka kufanya alter is table. So table name is sold underscore items. Items. Okay. So nakuja ku add primary key. So the same kama hivyo kwa you. So add primary. Okay. So add primary. Add primal key. Add primal key. A primal key, I create composite key. Okay. The first one will be transaction ID. So now copy it. Transaction ID. Okay. Copy it. Now we have paste hapa katika hiyo bracket. Then comma. Another will be medicine ID. So now copy it. So kuja hapa katika hii hapa. Neka comma. So combination of this one, transaction ID and medicine ID, nimeziassign hizi, nimeziassign kwenye single primary key ambayo ni hii, and this will be composite key. I think you understand. So after doing so, na add key. Okay, so now add key. So add key kwenye medicine ID. So just write medicine, add key kwenye medicine ID, then bracket medicine ID again. So just copy it kwa ajili ya kupunguza kuandika kodi, and come to duplicate. After doing so, now terminate. So hapa just weka koma, okay. So now copy it and come to the to paste kwenye GUI. So now hapa na copy paste katika GUI hii hapa. After pasting, naweza nikaja nika paste huku kwenye command line au nikaja nika paste kwenye GUI. After doing so, na click go button. Now you can see what imekuwa created. Hizo combination of primary key. So nikiklik on structure. Okay. So nikiki kwenye on structure ya sold items ambayo nime. Okay, so kwenye sold items ni click on structure. Now you can see kwenye hii describe. I have transaction ID. Transaction ID is the primary key. Now you can see key icon. And medicine ID is primary key. You can see key icon. And both in a quant key of Wapo. You can see this one. Me create a key. Okay. So now we know you call money composite key. Okay, see in the database we have a primary key, foreign key, alternate key, composite key, and super key. So tuna hizo keys kwenye database. So now you can see super keys so you can kwenye other tutorials. So how to get primary key? So hapa kuna kitu inaitwa functional dependence. Hiyo ni technique inayotumika kuweza kuipata primary key, ndio key ya mwisho kabisa. Okay? Functional dependence. So now kinachofuata sasa ni ku what ku modify kwamba hii kwenye medicine stock hapa tume specify ID is primary key. Tume specify kwenye medicine stock ID is primary key, but we want to make it auto increment. That is because unajiingiza ile ID inakuwa ni increment yenyewe. So now okay, kurudia hii hapa the same command, alter table medicine stock hii hapo. So now na andika keyword inofuata, so modify. Okay, hii modify, modify field inaitwa ID. ID ina modify kuwa int, kwa narudia int ile ile kuwa int, then is not null, is not null, then is auto increment. Nafanya hivi kama hicho. So after then na terminate, then na copy hii hapa code, nakuja kuipaste kwenye GUI au kwenye command line kama tulivyofundishana. Okay, so nakuja kuipaste hapa. So now paste it, press control button and hold, click enter to execute. I think there is an error. Okay, hapa kuna error. Alter table medicine stock modify modify ID is integer and not null and auto increment. So hapa kuna underscore, hapa kuna underscore, so put the underscore and then press control button, hold and click enter. Okay, now good, may execute. So final tunakuja ku create a foreign key. So now hapa hii tulikuwa tume specify primary key. Okay, hapa tulikuwa tume specify auto increment. Okay, auto increment, this is auto increment. Hapa tulikuwa tume specify what a primary key. Hapa tulikuwa tume specify a what a C is composite key. Okay, now hapa tuna specify what is foreign key. Okay, foreign key, specify foreign key. So nakuja hapa chini kwenye hii line hapa, nakuja ku specify foreign key kwenye sold item. So alter, I think in UDA, alter table sold items, now copy it and paste up sold items. So now we add a constraint. So add constraint. So add constraint. So now constraint na add kwenye sold item. So hapa naandika sold underscore items. So add constraint kwenye table name is sold item. Okay, then constraint is foreign key. So hapa naandika foreign key. Constraint is a foreign key. A foreign key column kwenye sold items ambayo ni hii hapa will be a medicine ID. So hapa kuja kuandika hapa medicine underscore ID. So this is a foreign key. So kinachofuata sasa hapa, hii medicine, a foreign key is a primary key. Still kuna kija hapa katika hii hapa. So what is FK? FK is foreign key. What is PK? PK is primary key. So foreign key is a primary key, okay, of another table. So primary key from particular table imekuja kutumika kwenye another table as a foreign key. So foreign key is a primary key as well from a particular table. Main objective is to show a relationship between two tables. Now, for example, is this is the T1 is table number 1, and this is T2 is table number 2. In T1, table number 1, we have a column inaitwa ID. And T2, table number 2, we have a column inaitwa medicine ID. Okay? So, what is the foreign key? Foreign key ni medicine ID kwenye table number 2. So, medicine ID will be a primary key of table 1 ambayo ni hii hapa. So, tumespecify hivi, itaonyesha relationship. Relationship in ER diagram, tunatumia what is diamond shape to show the relationship. So, it isn't by default relationship is one to many relationship. So, one, so in other side we will have this one is one, and other side we will have this one is many. So, relationship between a medicine stock and sold item. So, we can see kwamba in tuna tukifanya kwamba relationship hapa is in one to many. Kuna relationship. So, relationship yake ni nini? Ni kitendo cha kusell. Kitendo cha kusell. So, kwenye medicine sales zinafanyika kwenye medicine stock. Unaweza kusema concept kama hiyo. Nadhani hiyo concept imeeleweka vizuri. So, that is foreign key. Now, you should make references kuonyesha kwamba foreign key ni primary key of another table. So, keyword itakayotumika kuonyesha hii ni primary key ya table nyingine ni keyword inaitwa references. So, now unaandika hii hapa keyword inaitwa references. So, kwenye references unasema inarifaa kwenye what, inarifaa kwenye table gani? So, references is from medicine stock. Okay, kwenye medicine stock inafanya references kutoka kwenye ID. So, kwenye sold item, medicine ID is foreign key. References is medicine stock. And column name is ID. I think imeleweka hiyo. So, references na specify table name is medicine stock. Medicine underscore stock. Kwenye medicine stock, now una specify what field name is ID. Kwa hapa nime specify ID references. So another step, now you can specify other constraint, for example on, delete, cascade. You can specify this one on, delete, cascade, on, update, cascade, or you can say on, delete, no. So hapa hizi inaitwa referential target. So hizi inaitwa referential. Okay, I think kama sijakosea spelling, referential integrity kama inaandikwa hivyo, referential integrity. What is referential integrity? Referential integrity is about data togetherness. Okay, integrity. Okay, referential integrity, when I delete data kwenye mother table, hizo data zitaki kuondoka kwenye child table as well. So, what is referential integrity? Referential integrity una specify kwa kutumia primary key pamoja na foreign key. Na yenyewe rule yake inasema referential integrity ni kwamba deletion on mother table ambayo ina primary key is impossible. Why? Data inatumika kwenye child table yenye foreign key. Referential integrity rules deletion in mother table is impossible. Why? Data inatumika kwenye child table. Okay. Then updation kwenye mother table. Updation kwenye mother table ni possible. By default ita cascade update kwenye child table. But update in child table will not reflect update in mother table. That is default. Insertion kwenye child table ni possible if data ime exist kwenye mother table. Otherwise insertion kwenye child table ni impossible endapo data haija exist kwenye mother table. Wewe ni uwezi kuinsert, uwezi kuuza kitu ambacho hakipo kwenye inventory. Ndio maana hiyo ni concept rahisi kwa sababu wewe unauza kitu ambacho hakijasajiliwa. So ndio maana hiyo concept kwamba insertion in child impossible if data haija exist kwenye mother. So keywords zinazotumika ku specify ku force hiyo defaults, kuweka hiyo custom what constraint, mimi nataka ukifuta kwenye child ikafute kwenye mother, na ukifuta kwenye mother ikafute kwenye child. wakati ile default constant inakata. Uku update kwenye mother ka update kwenye child. Uki update kwenye child na update kwenye. So hii inference integrity una specify kwenye child table, not mother, kwenye child table ambayo inafanya reference. So keyword ya kwanza inaitwa on delete. Keyword ya pili inaitwa on update. Okay? On delete or on update. So can be on delete or on update. So hapa naweza kaja kuandika on delete or on update. Can be on delete or on update. So can be on delete can be cascade. Again, on update can be cascade. Or on delete you can say set default. Okay, so on delete unaweza kusema kwamba hii set default. What is default? A default is null. So nikija katika hii hapa command prompt, kuna ile sehemu ambazo nilikuwa naonyesha default. Hii hapa nilikuwa na describe table inaitwa sold items. Now you can see by default column ni null. That is default. By default column ni null. Lakini ukirememba kwenye hii sold items huku kwenye schema tulivyokuwa tuna specify kwenye sold items ambazo ni hizi, tulisema kote not null. Not null, not null, not null. Lakini huko anatuambia by default column inakuwa ni null. Kwa nikija hapa katika hii hapa kwenye hizi hapa tunazo specify, nikisema hapa sasa on delete, nikitoa hii cascade, nikiremove cascade, nikisema on delete set default, maana yake ina set kwenda kwenye null. Lakini kwa kesi yetu tulofanya hapa, nikisema on delete set null, hii command itaferi kwa sababu by default nimesha sema kwamba not null. Kwa hiyo nikitaka ile on delete set default, maana yake hizi not null niziondoe zote, ndio on delete ita set null kwa sababu column imekuwa turned to null. Now again you can say on delete set no action as well. So naweza ka remove on delete cascade, nikasema on delete no action. Okay, so on delete no action maana ni kwamba nikitaka kufuta inakataa, ndio no action. So I think you get the concept. So now tunatumia on delete cascade. Now you can say again on update cascade again. So now let's copy this command on my user interface, paste. Okay, now you can see our command about here. So alter table sold item, add constraint kwenye sold item. Constraint is foreign key, references, and on delete cascade, again on update cascade. Okay, so now execute, you can see now is executed. Now when I click on sold items, you click on structure, now you can see medicine ID is a foreign key. So click on particular database project farmers. After clicking, come to click on more, I think more, then click on designer. Okay, so click on designer. After clicking on designer, you can see this is a, I'm seeing you can see a logical schema somehow, but this is a logical schema. Okay, so his schema inaonyesha relationship. We have a one to many relationship between sold items and medicine stock. One to many relationship. And if you draw hapa, you can see here we have one, okay, and here we have many. I'm going to see kama unavyoonekana huko imekuja kwenye kana huko. Okay, relationship imefanyika kwenye hii column inaitwa ID, imekuja kwenye hii hapa medicine ID. So medicine ID hii ni just a foreign key. A foreign key references is ID, and on delete cascade, on update cascade. Okay, and this is out of stock ambayo yenyewe ni independent table. Okay, okay, so now you can see this is dependent table. So the item is a dependent table, this is independent, and this is independent. Okay, good. Another step is to insert data. So kuinsert data kuna technique mbili. The first technique kwa kutumia command line. Another technique ni kwa kutumia graphical user interface. So nikija hapa kwenye GUI, nikija hapa kwenye my database. Nikija kubonyeza hii hapa inaitwa what. Kumbuka hapa tuna mother table and child table. So tech table hizo zile zina foreign key na primary key. Mother table ni medicine stock. I think this is the mother table. Is mother table kwa nani? Kwa sold items. Tumesema kwamba huruhusi kuinsert chochote kwenye sold items. Huwezi kuuza kitu ambacho hakipo kwenye stock. So lazima ufanye register, uregister vile ambavyo kwenye medicine stock, baadaye ndio uje uzifanyie sales. So click on medicine stock. Click on insert. Now, ID tulisema ni auto increment, name is for example paracetamol. Name is paracetamol. And price is $5. And expired date, for example, this is expired date, for example. A number of quantities is 100. Again, now add another data. ID is auto increment. Name is aspirin, for example. What price, for example, is $10. Expired date, now specify expired date, for example, this one. What number of quantities, for example, 30. And then I click here, but I'm going to go. Good. After that, you click medicine stock. Now, in medicine stock, I have two records. Paracetamol and aspirin. In price and expired date in quantity. Now, tayari tumesha register stock. So now we have a stock. Kinachofuata ni kufanya sales. Ndani kufanya sales, nakuja katika sehemu imeandikwa sold items. Kwenye sold items, no records. Na click set. Insert mayake ndo nafanya sales. After then, hii transaction ID, hii ni auto-generate. Medicine ID. So which medicine I want to sell? So na click drop down arrow. I can see aspirin and paracetamol. So for example, I want to sell aspirin. Number of quantity 1. I sell 1. Okay. So let's total 3 here. For example, total. Let's put 0 by default for now. Okay. So now click enter or click go. Now you can see number of errors. Okay, integer value and so on. Kwa nini? Kwa sababu hapa tunachotaka kufanya. Here tume create a database. Na tunataka create information system application. Application have a number of sites. Let's show sites. First, application in a what we call is database. Another side in application we have logics. Another side of application we have template. So remember, kwenye application yoyote tutakayotengeneza, we have database. Database has already been created. What is logics? Logics is business logics. A business logics, hiki ambacho tunachokifanya hapa, hiki tunachokifanya hapa kinatakiwa kiwe implemented kwenye business logics. Na chikifanya kazi ya kufanya business logics is PHP. Kitachofanya kazi ya database ni SQL and MySQL. Kitachofanya kazi kwenye template ni HTML, okay, HTML and CSS, okay, yes, CSS, Bootstrap and so on. Good. So, kwenye logics can be PHP and a combination of JavaScript to create a business logics. What is business logics? Business logics, a set of operations kwa ajili ya kuachieve particular goals kwenye business. What is the goal of business? Our goal is, when I come to sell a particular product, for example, hapa, nikikliki on sales, or in certain doctors wenyewe, nikikliki on medicine ID, for example, I choose this one, nika select a quantity, for example, this one, total should be automatically created or calculated. Itakuwa calculated kwa kutumia business logics, na sio database kwa ikese ya namna hii. Okay, so hizo tunaweza kuzi specify kwenye information system. Information system ambao itakuwa ni what web application. Kisha tukishafanya logics, tuna put logics tunachukua hizi logics, tuja ku visualize kwenye template. Hizi logics kwenye templates zinakuwa visualized kwenye widgets, or you can say HTML tags, as well as widgets tunatumia Bootstrap. Kwenye template una visualize kwa kutumia what you can say metric cards, okay, metric cards, okay, or sometimes you can say tabular. Tabular is table, okay, tabular. We have number of what widgets kama vile now we have a late, we have a bootstrap model, okay, so we have a bootstrap model in so many. So hizi zinatumika kufanya templating ya what is computed in logics, na logics zinatoka kwenye database, okay. So after doing so, another step is to register number of what items in stock kwa kulewa utakaweza wewe. So register number of items kwenye stock, sababu ya ina shida, una register paracetamol, aspirin, panado, register number of items hapo. Then kitachofuata ni kuja ku create this application. After registering items, so for example paracetamol and aspirin, now we use template. So this is the template ndio tulizungumzia hapa. This is the template. Kwenye template we'll have what, kama nilivyoonyesha, this is a tabular nilizungumzia. A tabular is a table. Hapa naona nimefetch data. This is a paracetamol, aspirin, amoxicillin, ambao zipo kwenye nini? Zipo kwenye inventory. Our inventory, nikija hapa katika hii GUI ya our database, our inventory is medicine stock. Kwa hapa nime just kufetch na kuonyesha. Okay. Hii ni just a wewe widget kwa ajili ya kufilter. So these are the business logics. This is a business logics. When I come here, I select particular item, for example this one. And when I come to click sell button, now you can see error message. Error message is one or more items are out of stock. So hiki kijafanyika kwenye database. Hiki kimefanyika hapa hapa na JavaScript. So hiyo inaitwa nini? Business logics. Kwa hii inakuwa ni part ya application. Inakuwa ni same application, so database. As well as kwenye database unaweza kuimplement business logics, lakini in many cases tuna implement kwenye application. Nadhani kutaka kukupa faida kwamba ukitumia frameworks, for example, kama ukitumia frameworks, ukitumia website frameworks, maana yake hii database itakuwa converted kwenda kwenye model, okay. In case we might tumia Django, for example, hii logics itakuwa converted kwenda kwenye Vue. Hii template ina remain kwa template kutumia Laravel au Django. Why? Kwenye Vue ndo tuna implement business logics. Tuna compute, tunakuja tuna push kwenye template. Okay? Now good. So this is episode number 2 imekwisha, na concept ilikuwa ni database creation, table creation na other constraint. What is the constraint? Is null or not null? Another constraint is primary key, foreign key, and key. Okay? Okay, so now good. So save changes your application and see you next video series.